Hello everybody and welcome to a quick rinse of Super Metroid. It's a bit loud. Hey, what a menu screen. There's something about the Metroid menu screens that just makes me happy. And probably because they're really depressing. There's people dead on the floor here. Two on the left, one on the right. Depends on your perspective. I'm looking from the Metroid's point of view. I said it wrong and I'm correcting myself. I am Darren Gargette. And I've just played Super Metroid on the Wii U, which cost me 30 pence, which is probably bargain of the year. And if you bear me 1 second, I'm going to find out how to load my save from here. Oh, there we go. Good old emulation. So I'm going to start from the beginning because, you know, I think Metroid's all about exploring it for yourself. I don't want to start halfway through a Metroid quick rinse, partly because I've just finished it on the Wii U and I don't want to play it again. And partly because, you know, this scene is amazing for a start. You know, Samus running around on this sort of, you know, barren planet. Just go and find out for yourself what's on there. And yeah, so this is like, it's known as Metroid 3. Well, that's what it says at the start anyway. Or Super Metroid over here. But at the start of the game, it does say Metroid 3. Where, you know, the Metroid lava from Metroid 2 thinks you're his mother and saves you from the brink of death. And yeah, it's sort of like the continuing adventures from there. Now, you know, the term Metroidvania is you know, a much used one, and I can see why. It explains in short why a game plays, or how a game plays exactly how it does. You know, so in Metroid games, you see things like this, you're like, oh, I want to get down there, and you haven't got the morph ball yet. So what you need to do is look at the map and sort of, you know, think about where am I going, and you know, what's the next part of the map I can explore. So like, you see this wall up here. I love the SNES sounds. I don't know what it is about the SNES sounds, but listen. Not that one. The lightning. Where is it? It's just looped. That is just amazing. That is so, like, Super NES, you know. I can aim up, I can aim down by the use of the shoulder buttons. And the door, the coloured doors, like the pink ones, means I need to fire 5 missiles at it. And the blue doors means I can just fire anything at it and it opens up because it's like a cheap hooker. the one problem I have got Super Metroid in retrospect is that the doors aren't listed on the map. And I found this very frustrating when I went to explore the areas fully. Because I was like, well, if I don't know where the doors are or what I need to, you know, get through the doors. Because like, on Metroid Zero Mission and Fusion and stuff, they're listed on the map and what you need to open them with. And I think that's a great little touch just for a little bit more accessibility. And yeah, despite this game's obvious qualities, I'd still need that little bit more granular information on the maps to encourage me to explore a bit more. You don't see that very often in other Metroid games, the downwards door. I think they were a bit too complex for the more casual gamer. But this game is like a proper gamer's game. Like, you know, this isn't trying to cater to any market really, other than the guys who know how to play their Super Nintendo to its best, because this game is really tough at places. This is the start of the sort of, you know, the actual game of you exploring. There is a bit before that where you see the little lava Metroid that rescued you earlier, and it gets carried away by Ridley Scott, the metallic bird thing. And yeah, I guess the mission is now to find it. I love this. Much like Metroid Prime, I love the elevator sequences. Now this looks familiar, doesn't it? If you haven't played Metroid 1 or Metroid Zero Mission, which is a remake of 1, you would know that this is Planet Zeebs. This is Brinstar on Zeebs. And this is exactly how it goes on the NES version. You run left, you pick up the morph ball. And then in true Metroid fashion, you go, oh, right, okay, how do I use this morph ball? Get lost. You can't jump up there because your jump's just too short. So you roll into a ball and you lay a bomb. Do you lay a bomb? Oh, no, you shoot it first and then lay a bomb. There we go, I haven't got the bombs just yet. It took me ages to realise Samus has got to run. I always know that she's got the ability to run faster with the, you know, the boost ability, but it took me a little while to realise, even as a kid when I first played this game around a friend's house, he had it on and he left it at the certain bit where the wall sort of crumbles underneath you, and I never worked out how to get past it. And even like now, it's sort of it confuse my brain. Like, all good puzzle games should. All good puzzle games should confuse you at the same place every time. Well, either that or you get a better brain. But when I play Portal, Fez, this, like, I always get stuck at the same puzzles. And I, you know, I like it for that. And just the feeling of isolation in a Super NES game. It's ridiculously, like, well done. Like, yeah, you're on your own. Like, oh, where am I going? And, you know, it sort of feels familiar because, you know, this is the Metroid 1 world. And in true Metroid fashion, the map will indicate if there's an item in that square, in that room. But it doesn't go away in Super Metroid. Another problem I have with it, in retrospect, after playing many more modern versions of Metroid games. See the little dot inside the room, it's still there. And I just think, get rid of that, because that's a bit misleading. Because to my stupid brain, I'll probably think, oh yeah, there's still an item there. You know, and as brilliant as this game is in terms of gameplay, I still feel like it needs a... It could do with a remake. Not a HD remake, but something like they did with Symphony of the Night on Xbox Live. Like, you know, modernise it. And do a few little tweaks here and there. But don't... Oh, that is amazing. Just the little bleeps and the blobs. I want this in, like, installed in my house. So when I'm walking down a corridor, it just goes bleep, 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 bleep. So as you can see, I picked up a missile expansion there, which allows me to have up to 10 missiles. And now the place is infested with space pirates. No, they're not space pirates, are they? They're Super Metroid. And after this is Metroid Other M, the only Metroid game I've never... No, and Metroid 2. I've never finished Metroid 2. The original Metroid, because it's just like... I don't want to play a NES game, in, you know, nowadays, really, if I can help it. And Other M. I started playing Other M, and I found the controls to be too hard. No, not too hard, but just too frustrating. Like, just the Wii remote. Are you joking? This is like a... It's like a Ninja Gaiden-style action game, you know? Even a laugh, just a Wii remote. That game could do with a remake. Fuck it, just make all the Metroids. So now I've got the 10 missiles that look suspiciously like a penis. I can now open this door that I haven't been into before. And, you know, what I like to do is, because the doors aren't listed on the map, I like to just get one square in and then run away. And then, because it's marked on the map now that I haven't explored that room fully. That's sort of my way of getting around the no doors on the map situation. And now I can go in here. Hooray! But I can't get any further because I haven't got the bombs yet. Oh, no. You know, this kind of game has been, not replicated, but, you know, used with Guacamelee recently. Although not as strong. Like, Guacamelee is quite a soft version of this. And I wonder if, like, developers are scared of using this format, like, in today's, like, you know, to its extreme like this. Like, you know, proper hardcore. I don't know if it's, like, even Dust and Legion Tail had, like, you know, echoes of a Metroidvania. I don't know, I just think, much like F-Zero, I think Nintendo are scared of doing a game like this again, because it'll scare away a certain audience. But if you make it right, if you don't go mental on the budget, you're going to sell to a certain amount of Nintendo fans. Make your money back. Let's face it, not every game needs to hit that fucking Call of Duty money. So, save stations here. And unlike Castlevania Symphony of the Night, these ones make sense. You think, oh, there's a little pod there, what do I do? Unlike a heart-beating decahedron in the background. Doesn't really make a lot of sense, does it? Ha! Ha! Right then, let's find our way through the next area, and then I'll disappear. If you're interested in this game, you can buy it on the Wii U. By now, it would have run out, but the 30p deal is an absolute bargain. I don't know if you can buy it, really. I mean, eBay, get a SNES. Hold on, I've gone the wrong way, and I'll go this way. Boom, I love that music. It's classic. Oh, get lost. So yeah, like enemies respawn in these rooms, so you want to like keep going in and out. Oh, one more. To farm the items and stuff. Here comes another Chozo. Give me an item, please. Ah, look at that little picture of Samus. That's rubbish. It's like a little thing. What's it from the Fantastic Four? Oh, it's called the thing, isn't it? Hello? Doors. Uh-oh. I'm going to die. Ah. Whoa, frame rate. Yeah. Alright, thanks for watching. This has been Super Metroid, a classic. If you like video games, this has to be played. I don't really say that about a lot of games, but I think the Super Nintendo has a lot of these games where you have to play them. And I sound like a real fanboy, like Nintendo fanboy, but I genuinely mean that. Like this and Link to the Past. Humdingers! Thanks for watching. I have been a morph ball. Armadillo! It's smooth on the outside and crunchy on the inside. Still wearing it. See you later!